Hey guys, you're probably here because you want to know all about vitamin D, such as what are the signs and symptoms of vitamin D deficiency, and what foods and supplements should you take to help prevent it? Well, I'm going to answer that question, along with many other questions, in this week's Responding to Your Comments, where we look at fun questions, we look at science-based questions, but most importantly, we always look at the evidence. Coverage G. Hi Abraham, I'm a massive fan of your work. Can you please do a video on vitamin D? Coverage G, sending you awesome vibes. Obviously, being a massive fan, I'm definitely going to pick this comment to talk about. But being realistic as well about vitamin D, fun fact for you all to know, 1 in 5 people have low vitamin D. So I thought this is a great comment, it's a great question to talk about more. And I know that a lot of people do think that sunshine is the best source for vitamin D, and it is a source, of course. But there are far safer sources of vitamin D as well, such as from your diet. For example, salmon and mushrooms have a high amount of vitamin D in them, which is really good. And also in the winter, it's useful to know that it is advised to take a vitamin D supplement. But I'm going to be talking about all of these later on in the video as well. Now, before we begin, let's go back to the basics. So firstly, where does vitamin D actually come from? Because it is true, your skin does make vitamin D using UVB rays from the sunlight. But you can also get vitamin D from various foods that are high in vitamin D. However, it is important to remember that your liver and kidney are responsible for transforming that vitamin D into a form that your body can actually use. Now, vitamin D is vital for calcium and phosphate absorption, which is going to help keep your bones and teeth strong and healthy. Which is why when you don't have enough vitamin D, you're at risk of getting things like rickets and osteomalacia. But I will discuss these a little later on in the video. Now, vitamin D also helps to stop your muscles from cramping. It's also a natural anti-inflammatory. It also boosts your immune system. It helps nerve cells communicate with each other. And it even helps to control blood glucose levels. All of these make vitamin D a 5-star vitamin. Now you may be thinking to yourself, you know what Abraham, that sounds great. Vitamin D, this 5-star vitamin, does all these things, that's amazing. So I'm gonna go sit in the sun all day and get as much vitamin D as possible. But please stop right there. Because if you're gonna do that, it has a lot of risks. And also, if you're gonna be in the sun all day, and how much vitamin D your skin actually makes, can vary depending on many different factors. So for example, your skin tone can be one of them. How long you spend in the sun. All of these different things vary the amount of vitamin D that we produce, which is why it's really important that yes, you do spend some time in the sun, that's perfectly fine, but you also have a healthy, balanced, varied diet that boosts that vitamin D level. We're gonna talk about that a little later on. But please remember, don't just go and sit out in the sun without any sun protection on, because all you're gonna do is them UVB rays and the UVA rays from the sunlight and they damage your skin and potentially put you at a much higher risk of getting sunburn and potentially skin cancer. So it's really important that you always wear a sunscreen. If you're ever confused about what sunscreen to wear, which sunscreen to buy, I did make a video about it not long ago and I will link it up here and in the description. So feel free to check it out if you want more information. So moving on, your next best source of vitamin D is in food. Certain foods have really high levels of vitamin D. So for example, egg yolks and oily fish like salmon. These are notoriously high in vitamin D. But it doesn't mean to go crazy on eating egg yolks. So it doesn't mean, oh, I'm gonna eat 20 egg yolks a day to get my vitamin D, because it doesn't work like that. And that's actually gonna have a negative health effect for you. So you need to eat things in moderation, just like you do at the moment, a healthy, balanced amount. Now, loads of different foods have different levels of vitamin D in them. And if we go through it all in this video, we will be here till tomorrow. So the best thing to do is I'm gonna leave a link and some information in the description below to a really useful table. It's got loads of different foods and their amount of vitamin D in them. So I'd highly recommend that you do read it. You may have also heard of foods that are fortified with vitamin D, or you might have even seen them on packaging of certain food products when you go in the supermarket, and you might be wondering to yourself, what does that mean? Well, it's very simple. All it means is that vitamin D has been added, so fortified means it's been added to that food during its manufacturing process. So for example, it's quite commonly seen on cereals, fat spreads, and non-dairy milks. Now here's another fun fact for you. You can actually get super mushrooms now that are very high in vitamin D, which are treated with UVB light when they're growing. So remember when we spoke about the UVB earlier? This is exactly why it's important that we talk a little about the science first, because it all now makes sense. Now, there's also certain foods that they say are very high in vitamin D, which sadly, that is not the truth. So for example, I've seen it on tomatoes, peppers and potatoes. They sometimes say that these are superfoods that are high in vitamin D, but sadly, that is not the case. Now, at this point in the video, I just wanted to quickly remind you that if you ever feel worried that you might have low vitamin D levels, please speak to your healthcare professional first so they can check your symptoms, they can ask you questions, and if it's needed, they will do a blood test to check for vitamin D deficiency. Okay, now let's move on to the symptoms of vitamin D deficiency. Now, unfortunately, the symptoms of vitamin D deficiency are very broad. And what I mean by that is, let's say, for example, I was running and I sprained my ankle and it really hurts, okay? The symptoms of a sprained ankle are very narrow, they're very specific. So, for example, I might have inflammation of my ankle, I might have pain in that region, might have pain around the area. So it's a very sort of specific pain. Now, with vitamin D deficiency, unfortunately, it's quite a broad symptom list. So for example, you might feel tired, you might feel weak, and you may also have joint pain, muscle pain, or even bone pain. Now, vitamin D deficiency in children can actually cause rickets. So this is where our bones become very soft and bendy. And in adults, it can actually cause osteomalacia. Now, if you want more information on both of these, I am going to leave some links in the description below for you. Okay, so we're now getting to the good bits. Vitamin D supplements, should you take them? And if so, which ones should you take? Well, in the UK, during September to March, the Department of Health recommends that all adults should take a vitamin D supplement. So basically, during winter, September to March, they should take a vitamin D supplement, which is 1,000 units per day. Now, there are certain people who are at high risk of low vitamin D. For those individuals, the Department of Health recommends that they take 400 units of vitamin D a day throughout the year. Now, you're probably thinking to yourself, well, that's great, Abraham, but who is at risk of low vitamin D? Well, the list, my friends, is actually quite long. So I'm gonna tell you a few, which are the quite common ones, but I will leave the full list in the description below, and I'd highly recommend that you all read it. So the more common ones include, if you have dark skin, you're at higher risk. If you spend a lot of time indoors, okay, that puts you at higher risk as well. And also, if you cover up a lot of your skin when you go outdoors, again, higher risk. So the 1000 unit vitamin D tablet here in the UK is the default OTC ones that they sell in the community pharmacies. So most community pharmacies, do double check with them firstly as well, but they will sell the 1000 unit tablet. That is the most common one that everyone has. And it's usually recommended as well, after a course of vitamin D treatment dose, to take the 1000 unit tablets long-term as well. But always speak to your doctor or healthcare professional about doing this, but that is usually the recommendation. Okay, so I really do feel like you're becoming a bit of a vitamin D pro now. You now know all about the science behind vitamin D, how it's made, certain foods that are high in vitamin D, what symptoms to look out for vitamin D deficiency, what dose to take of vitamin D and if it's required at all. So you really are becoming a bit of a pro. But you already know about the tablet, but it's also important to remember that you can get vitamin D in many other different forms. So let's have a quick look at them. First off, we have the Humble Vitamin D tablet. Easy to swallow and never disappoints. Next up, we have the liquid filled pearl capsule. Smoother than tablets, and just look at that fantastic color. But remember folks, this is a medicine, not candy. So keep out of reach and sight of children. Next up, we have liquid vitamin D drops. Easy to pop in your drink or drop directly on your tongue. There's also vitamin D liquid. Make sure to have the right size spoon or syringe before taking this one. Liquid vitamin D is also available as a spray. However, unfortunately, I don't have one here to show you, but a quick spritz before work or on your way out, if you're in a rush, this one might be the one for you. So as you can see, the range of supplements can be quite overwhelming. So the best advice I can give all of you is always speak to your pharmacist first or any healthcare professional so they can speak to you and give you a better idea of what vitamin D to take, how to take it, and always read the information leaflet that comes with any medicine or supplement, just so you can make sure that you're safe and suitable to take it. That is the most important thing that everyone should be doing. So Coverage G, thank you for your comment. I really hope you find this information useful, and I really hope you, the viewer who is not Coverage G, also finds this information helpful. You are now a bit of a vitamin D pro, so tell your friends, tell your family, tell your loved ones, tell your colleagues, Tell everyone, tell some random person on the street, because you know all about vitamin D and you can guide them to the right direction. I really hope you find this information helpful. Now, let's move on to the next comments. So it looks like we've run out of time again in this week's episode of responding to your comments. If I didn't get back to your comment, I'm really sorry. We get so many comments these days, so it's really hard to fit them all into one episode. The best advice I can give all of you is just leave another comment. Keep commenting, and eventually I will get back to you in a future episode. That's the end of this week's video. Always remember you're awesome, and I will see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.